Hey, here we are again, folks, and we just need to light the fire here in a minute. And I think we have to, instead of build a fire, just flip a switch here in a minute. And I think we're going to do that. In fact,
There
as
it
you watch,
goes.
you'll probably see flames. Oh, there they are. There they are. So good to see you. Welcome. We're going to thank God for what He's going to do in this stream. And you're welcome to bring others into it, do a watch party. Hello to Laura and David right off the bat as I look here. And, people might not be as accustomed to the fact that we're coming to you at this hour. So just go ahead and share that. Some people might need to know. And I noticed a little light, maybe this is impossible to fix, reflecting into the back here. So we'll see if we can fix
I'll
that.
Try.
And you're in here, folks, you're in on the experiment with us. So I appreciate all of that. I appreciate all that you've been to the show. And we're just gonna relax and just look to see what God's going to do next. I had a really good stream earlier, and God just showed up, as usual, showed up. And I was just thinking about this before I came on the air, that the more we relax, the more God's doing. So I just wanted to encourage everyone to relax. I think it's this one here. See, I just blocked it there. And it's actually kind of tilted right on my head. Any face, I don't even know if I need that much light on my left side. So folks, you're kind of in on it. Isn't it fun to see the behind the scenes? I saw Peter just walk into the door. He's in the foyer. Were you doing duck duty?
Yep.
Good, good.
No, it's not this one.
And, okay. It might be the overhead. But God, just enjoy the process with it, folks. It's not always going to be this much fun. We might accidentally get it perfect one of the days. It's just not going to be as much fun. You're right, James. It's not going to be. I like it. And we're looking, reading back on into Pat Robertson's history with the 700 Club. The parts that I remember the most are the humorous ones in which they had once I think he said, this was way, way back when they just had like some country station and some kind of old TV station. It was, the shack was almost falling apart. I think they had a technician just crawling across live. It'd be as if somebody's crawling behind me here with a wire or something.
We're pretty close to that.
But the part I really remember that we haven't gone through really recently at any rate is the one of two listeners. I think you had two listeners and they only had like a mile or two reach. So I just appreciate those memories. And that got rid of the worst of it. I kind of wonder if
we're gonna have to stick with that.
Yeah, I wonder if we even need that light or if we want to throw something over it.
Yeah.
So God, just we're gonna get it right. We'll get it before the next show, folks. We'll get it all fixed. But just come on in, just enjoy the camaraderie, enjoy all the things that God's doing, flowing, touching lives, and just we want to have an atmosphere of relaxation here as we come together. So it's just, here we are. Just come on in, and we'll start with the first song. Don't forget.
I will shout and I'll sing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing. I'm standing on the promises of Christ, my Savior. Standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, and by the living word of God I shall prevail. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing. I'm standing on the promises of Christ, my Savior. Standing. I'm standing. I'm standing on the promises of God.
folks. Good to see you again. And that was just a good start to the day. I really appreciated the afternoon session. And we're gradually combining the private Facebook room with this public one. Now, in this public Facebook room, we're open to the whole world. The private room had its advantages. For 13 months, we used it as a way of getting to know each other and creating almost like a 13-month retreat, you might say, 1,500-plus members. And that gave us a base. And you know what it reminds me of? Well, my doctors at one time, the father-son duo, they had 2,000 patients. And I thought to myself, 2,000? I only see 3 to 5 to 10 people in the waiting room at any given time. And then I realized it's sort of like this stream. We have a base of 1,500, but at any given time, snapshot, when I do a live session, I have 3 to 5, 10, 15 people. And so that was the case again today. So it's really neat that we have this base. We've all come to know each other, and God seems to have graduated us now, saying, okay, now go forth, go out and give that you might receive. So I'm asking you to do some watch parties. Some of you have done this and brought in some people. We've been growing. And I just wanted to kind of welcome a few people I missed earlier. Thank you, Christy, for being here during the afternoon session and for sharing your story. Also, Chavez up there in Chicago. I have fond memories of you tuning in recently. And I think you said you were even standing outside listening to this. So I had a kind of a picture, and you showed where in Chicago you are. And you told me, and I looked it up on Google Street View. So my son is up there now in your city, not too far from you, within a fairly short drive. And hello to Amy Fenton, who likes this song. Donna Dean, Casper, good to see you. And Jackie, good to see you back here again. One of our members who goes back the longest, almost 2 decades, to the earlier old message boards we had in the pre-Facebook days. And couldn't make the afternoon, says Donna Dean, because of a doctor appointment. But they're grateful to have medical care when so many don't. God bless you. And you can always replay these. Seth, good to see you. Great to see Seth in here. Seth Arndt. And God, here we are. I might have missed greeting somebody. Again, because we discovered the success of this watch party feature, you can just invite people right now. You can do a watch party. James can always explain it. If you don't know how, just post a message and James can explain it. I have to assume most of you know how to do a watch party. But it's a way of just putting an announcement on your Facebook page so that people who are, I guess, friends or who follow you will see this.
Yeah, and any of their friends should see it.
Any of your friends. And it's a way of, one lady did this, the lady who kind of suggested to us. I don't know if you're listening to that, Debbie. She said in one show, 140 people at least checked out the watch party. And out of that, some, I'm sure, come into the stream. And we had our largest night last night. So thank you, folks, for bringing people in. We're going to try to continue to grow and get some real momentum. February is a good time to do it. It's a time when people are inside. In our country, the sun sets, maybe not in Australia or New Zealand, but in our country, the sun sets early. It's cold generally. They spend a lot of time indoors. It's probably no coincidence that we have a lot of listeners from Michigan at this time of year and to the north. So you're all welcome to keep coming in. Let's bring revival to our country one person at a time. Instead of feeling so helpless, you now, through this new technology and through the watch party feature, you can, even if you're the most shy person, can still press that button, watch party, and you just became an evangelizer. So God, just anoint us and show us the way here. Show us how to expand our community. And this gives you an outlet for the times when, did you ever feel helpless when you watch things happening in the country or in your own community or in your own family? And this gives you an outlet. You could actually, by the end of the day, know that I did something out there on the open internet in the marketplace of ideas. And thank God we're still in a freedom of expression mode for our country. I just did something. I just proclaimed the good news, basically. Okay, well, let's go to the next song. Caleb's over here behind me, and he's handling things alone. We don't have a piano accompaniment because Nathan, I think, has a video depot to cover. I'll check the messages later. You can also private message me. Some people are at that stage where they prefer that, so I'll check them during the songs.
To my words, O Lord, consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God. my prayer unto thee and will look up. Give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King and my God. For unto thee will I pray. My voice shalt thou hear in the morning. O Lord, in the morning will I direct my prayer unto thee and will look up.
Hey, I'm back again, and just wanted to thank everybody for being here in the family. Some are out still doing things, but we're all here. Thankfully, we have a large family, we can always have somebody standing at the controls and at the guitar and, you know, getting ready to every evening present this to you right here from the living room. And when I can't do it from the living room, I've been doing it one-on-one with you. We're coming up with all sorts of exciting things. One of the things we're doing, and I don't know if Christy's still on here, but I today asked those who have a praise report of, or some way to express what God has done since you became a member of this community, just to sort of build up our trust and have something encouraging to put up in a praise report section. And today I asked you, Christy, if you're still there, and you sent it to me, and you're the first one. If anybody else has something that you feel like God has done through this community that he has created, let us know. And I like to give it to Luke, who's going to help me assemble and create a section for famteam.com. We're trying to, in this 20th year of famteam.com, make some changes to it, actually make an app. And this will be a resource for people who are down and alone in the middle of the night. They can visit there and look at all these praise reports. And I'd like to even have some done with video. So if somebody would even like to have their story done, well, I could sort of interview you for a couple of minutes. It wouldn't have to be right away. It could be on a day we set, like, oh, next week at this time. Then that way you could be prepared. Maybe, you know, you can figure out where you're going to put your phone so you can, or your whatever monitor you use, whatever camera you use on your computer, and you could get ready, wear the dress or the suit, or, you know, whatever guy or gal wants to wear, get your hair right. You know, just everybody wouldn't have to be thrown on right away. Now, some people don't mind coming on as they are, but we would set that up and create an interview. And what we'd do is put those videos along with the written good praise reports in this section. Isn't that great? We're going to have enough material here to keep you on here 24/7. We're trying to replace the outright bad stuff that we're watching that is normally out there. The media menu that we've had for the last 30 or 40, 50 years hasn't been that good. Hollywood, TV shows, music, just popular, just the whole atmosphere, college campuses, politics. We need to realize that, wow, you know, it doesn't have to be that way. So let's just follow what Jesus said, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. We're going to do all we can with God to create a little slice of heaven here in cyberspace. And also we're trying to do that with these 25 acres of woods and fields and creeks, creating a place where you can come. Our next gathering will be on Memorial Day weekend if people want to come and get refreshed and meet each other. Hello to Paul from down there in Florida. Paul, Mark, and Jacob wrapping up their second last day in Florida. They're down there on a wedding outing and having some fun, visiting lighthouses and looking at beautiful sights going along the coastline. Hello to Marie Freddy, good to see you once again in here. Ashley in California, nice to see you. Glad I received your private message earlier. God bless you. And Sandy, good to see Sandy from, I believe, the Northwest, right? And let's just remember that it's not just a feel-good atmosphere here or a feel-good positive session, positive thinking session, but we're coming empty and hungry and letting God fill us. We're coming humbly and not coming and saying that we earn God, anything from God, but we're coming empty-handed, asking him to always wash us clean through the sacrifice of Jesus, but making that come alive to us by welcoming his Spirit. As we go to the next song, you're all welcome to send a message, put it publicly, or those who like to do it privately, I can glance at those during the songs. Let's be back shortly. Hey, I'm aiming the camera. Good job there. Good job there. And just welcome folks back again. I have my phone on.
Are you live there?
Yeah, I turned on conversations with Dad briefly. Oh, that's okay. Yeah, okay. Well, anyway, poor people will be confused. Yeah. Do they, well, I'll talk to you during the next song. But I just want to kind of say, folks, that this is something that started on, it's easy to remember, a month before Valentine's Day of 2019. Now we're doing on 2020. We're 13 months and 5 days into this experiment. but only about 2 weeks into this experiment of doing this in a wide open internet. So I've been asking all of you to keep doing a watch party. I think, hello, Kelly Hopper. I think I saw you do one earlier. Good to see you. And Enid, you're not feeling very well. So why don't we pray for you? Your stomach's really been hurting. So God, I'm just going to take this oil and just thank you, God, that we have it on hand. And put that, God, just send your spirit. Thank you, God. Amen. Just come, Jesus, come. We're just sending your spirit. I had to close out the other one. Now I'm going to just anoint you. God, just send Ina. She's been one of our most faithful listeners from down there in Texas. I really appreciate it. She even appreciates the drives. We went on one today, and you got to see your favorite trees. So God, just touch her. I'm so glad you said, Enid, that God's already relieving you of the depression and anxiety while you're in these. It just seems like it lifts for you while you're in the streams. I think that's God's presence and anointing. And I just feel a real faith that that sense of peace, that healing could keep going even when you're not in the stream. I pray that that'll touch your health and touch every part of you 24/7, that you'll have a new normal of his presence and constant healing, and that God will close any doors that are bringing misery to you in any way. Anything that's not God's will, we just, in the name of Jesus, just command that to dissolve and just invite God's presence into every part of your life. You're welcome, Sue, and from Pennsylvania, inviting. You said thank you for praying for my shoulder and arm, and we're glad that you're here. We invite you to come in all the time, you and your husband, and welcome anybody else, anybody, any of your friends. We would like to have friends and friends of friends. Hello, Kim Adkins from Alabama. Good to see you. It's always good to hear from that state. I finished reading another Civil War book from a woman who was a Confederate nurse in Alabama during the Civil War. And she was from Mobile, but she also went all over the place, Montgomery and all over the state, actually. So it was Opelika, I think, everything. So just good to hear from you, and God bless you. And I'm going to try to scroll down to see who else might have popped in during that song. And, by the way, I might sound repetitive, but we're going to be here usually every night at 8 p.m. Central, except tonight, 7. But also, I've been doing them during the days. You might have to be alert for the signal, but I've been trying to do them at 2 p.m. Central, okay? Also, you'd please put the watch party notice out there. I just want to also thank the team. I'd say mainly the hardest workers in this have been the musicians and James, who does the audiovisual. I don't know if you want to say a quick hello, both of you. We can put the camera on you.
I don't have a camera on Caleb.
That's okay.
But we can hear him.
Yeah, maybe. You can hear Caleb.
Here,
and
say it again.
James
hello,
is over
this
there,
is my
too.
Voice. Speaking voice.
Yep, and that's me over here.
Yeah, and we appreciate the guys. Three of our guys are down in Florida covering a wedding, and also one of them is in Chicago covering a court reporting assignment. So sometimes they tune in. Oh, you live close to Montgomery, Kim. Good, good. Good to hear from you. Well, you're all welcome to come in as often as you want. Keep spreading the word. This is finally a way that instead of being so concerned about what's coming over the country or the world or the culture, we can kind of not only push back, but take ground. And I don't mean in a human way, because maybe we can put that scripture up about the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. And maybe Ephesians 6, if you don't mind putting that all up there, James, we can, we try to let the Spirit lead us as we talk about what part of God's truth is coming alive, not to just have a cold textbook approach to it, which isn't wrong. Some people are meant to study a textbook, like in a textbook fashion, but we do it kind of in a living fashion. And, welcoming God's Spirit as he kind of brings alive and kind of quickens this to us. And speaking of quickening, which means bringing to life, we also have a quickening in the sense of speeding up what's been happening, because we really feel that we found a way to spread this during 2020. The watch party idea is excellent. And people gradually become more and more confident and excited about being a part of this. See, so many times Christianity has been presented as something you do in a passive way. Plus, a lot of people in their situations, especially since we have a lot of moms, grandmas, great-grandmas in here, or even single women, you sometimes wind up feeling a little helpless. You might almost feel like events are out of your control. You might be the main believer in your circle, and you're just almost like playing whack-a-mole instead of feeling like just a responder to things. And on top of that, look at all that's happening in the world, and maybe somebody in a family is addicted, or maybe this is happening, or financial problems. We can actually take leadership this way with God. We can actually take the leadership. Isn't that fantastic? Hey, that's neat how you put that up there. Can you put the scripture?
I doubt you'll be able to read it. It's awfully tiny.
No, but I could read up here. Can you put it up for them where they see me and that? That's pretty neat.
I've tried that before, and it doesn't quite work because you can see it's because this is left to right. I'd have to have such narrow columns to be able to.
Yeah, but still, even that works.
Yeah.
You might maybe just upper right. It's good old James.
Now this is I'd have to take a few minutes and set this up.
Well, either way, but something could consider.
Yeah.
I want to say Chandra, good to see you, another Alabaman, and just right up the road. Is that right? So you might have made a friend there down in Alabama. Good to see you. And I enjoy watching Alabama and Auburn softball. You know, I really like baseball, Major League Baseball. I like, you know, just any softball, guys having home run contests. And girls, college softball is fantastic because it's amateur and everybody brings out their families. And two of the best teams are Auburn and Alabama. Joanne, good to see you. Good to see you. And we were going through the South once, Kathy and I, on the way to Williamsburg. We honeymooned in Williamsburg, Virginia. We often go through the Southeast on the way there. And once we were going through the Alabama, near Alabama or in Alabama a few years ago, we went to a rest stop where they had a guard or a forest ranger or somebody in one of these nicer rest stops where they'll have, you know, you go inside and have a lobby in the map, you are here, and, you know, and maybe a real nice bathrooms. But this guy was watching an Alabama softball game. So it shows you how down in Alabama, the major league sports or the college sports. And we noticed the same thing in Georgia when we go through and see Georgia on the big G of Georgia on the mailboxes. So anyway, it's good to see everybody here. And we're going to, I'm just kind of scrolling through. Some of you are from the past, different eras, like Jackie. So get to know each other. Some are current. And it's really neat. I was telling Kathy, it's almost like kind of neat because when somebody passes away, people come out of the woodwork to come to the funeral home. People who knew you so long ago, people whom you just met. It's kind of a shame that the person couldn't live to see this family reunion. Well, here we're getting to see our life put, you know, the old, the new, everything coming together, relatives, because this kind of technology brings us together. I really think that this will bring people in who are in your family. See, people who wouldn't come to your house, maybe, or your church, or you couldn't come up with a conversation about eternity or Jesus or sin, you could just send an invitation and say, hey, in case of, you know, if you, in case of emergency, break glass. You know, if you really get down, don't give up. Tune into this. And they can slip their way into the community. I'm sure some of you out there are probably listening. In the last 24 hours, I received a message from someone who said, hey, I've been kind of an undercover listener, but I appreciate this very much. I forgot even the person's name, but thank you for the lady. I thought it might have been Marie. But anyway, just appreciate it. It was someone who I had never heard from, who's out there. So you're allowed to be hidden here. You can message me privately until you get up the courage to come in here. The fire looks nice, says Chandra. Yeah, this is, you know, going back, you know, to our early days. We were married going on 41 years. In the early days, we had at our old house, which is a turn of the century old frame house, like you see in It's a Wonderful Life. We had a regular real fireplace, and every once in a while we would have logs. And when the kids were little, I would build a fire, but it had to be sparingly. This is a fake fire, but it looks kind of real, doesn't it? It actually has logs in there.
It's a real fire.
The fire is real. It's not a movie of a fire, you know. Yeah.
You know, funny thing is, we were actually talking about, it's just we don't have, this will give away a secret in case we ever do it. But we were talking about cutting out just the frame of, just recording the fire.
Yeah.
A good like hour long loop of it.
Yeah.
Then we could superimpose that for each future video.
Yeah, that way when it's 95 degrees outside, we could still have a fire. Well, for that matter, you could superimpose me and just use the same me for every program and just dub me with new words.
Yeah, right. It's just a rerun. Yeah.
You know, I revolve wearing these hooded sweatshirts. They show the various places. We love this country, all the beautiful places we go. And so a lot of times, this one is in New York City. It's Western New York, which is about as rural as you can get. It's really beautiful. People who are close to the earth, God-fearing people. Western New York State. And is anybody familiar with that? Anyway, we're filming up there. And this is where I got this. New York, established in 1788. It has a picture of an elk or something, a deer right here. So this is in New York City. And we have been to New York City. We had to drive there as the whole family wants to be on the Montel show. But this is a lot different part of New York. We're in Illinois. We're at the other end of, we're about on the other end of the state from Chicago. It's about 5 hours away, about 300 miles. We're close to the Mississippi, close to St. Louis, close to the Arch. And Chandra says, pray for my friend's daughter. She just found out, okay, her breast cancer has returned. and is starting chemo and radiation again. So I'm going to pray, God, just send your spirit. We've seen a lot of touches, a lot of healings, signs and wonders, and I received today another one. I don't know if Chrissy, you're still there, but you talked about how God instantly touched you and gave you a restoration, what, a year and a half ago? And it's stuck, hasn't it? Send your spirit, God, in Jesus' name, on this friend and her daughter. Just touch this whole thing. Come, Holy Spirit, touch. Thank you, Jesus. Pray that this disease will be contained and not spread to other parts of her body or to lymph nodes. I pray that you would guide those who are giving the chemo and radiation. Give her peace and use this whole thing as a way to have her draw close to you and your people even more. And also just heal it and purify her whole body away from this and just give it replacement with, just replace it with your health and every cell, every part of her in Jesus' name. And by the way, she's welcome to come in here. The beauty of it is people can, during times of stress, they have somebody, a community, once they get to know everybody here, they can take this into hospital situations with them, and it's a real comfort to them. It's been a comfort to me during stressful situations. This group has been a great replacement or a distraction, times when I feel alone or my mind is just turning over a problem that I can't fix. Ina says they have one of those. The dogs love lying on their pillows in front of it. Yeah, that's, dogs always like fires. It does. The fire doesn't get you warm when you sit by it, Laura. Not too much. It might eventually, if we cranked up the heat, it might. But we purposely don't overdo it. And in summer, I like to even do this in summer. We might have to open the close the windows and run the AC a little bit. It doesn't throw out a huge amount of heat. Whoops! I just disappeared. The group just disappeared on me. I just hit the wrong swipe. I swiped the left baby when I should have swiped right. And anyway, I'll just ask somebody to fix this, and then I'll go to that scripture.
I did set that up. What you saw on screen, I could show it to them now.
Yeah, okay. And could you, anybody know, do you know anything about this pad? Maybe somebody's grabbed this and deliver it. Maybe you could be a courier and bring it over to a
courier.
Yeah, and but I just want to thank you for what you're going to do. God, you're going to do this in the next, I don't know, 20 minutes left. I just feel like you're going to keep touching two or three people, especially, I think, have a real appointment to be touched tonight. Just touch those two or three people. If you're one of them, I kind of feel like one of the symptoms of feeling that you're one of the ones is you have a real, you feel like a cracked desert, like the dirt, almost like a drought. Almost, I see a picture of dirt that's just dry as can be, so dried out that it actually is cracking. And God, just pour the streams, just pour it, pour your streams of life there, and just let all the water, the earth become sort of cracked and dry, and all of that, just fill it. Thanks, and make it to how it should be, God. Plant something, make it fertile and tender soil.
So, Ted, I wonder, you can consider this if you want, instead of looking behind you, you could pull up the ESV translation on your phone.
Oh, yeah.
And just read from there.
Yeah.
And then I'll just follow along with you.
Wait a minute, this, the translation on my phone, where would it actually, what specific part of the, would I hit? What button?
Well, I guess if you have just your Bible app on the phone. And then...
Which app?
If you go to your Bible on your phone.
Oh, yeah. I got you. Yeah.
And just instead of turning behind you to see it on the big screen.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that's a good point. Hello, Jessica, Danny. I saw your name just pop up. Yes. I almost could read it up there if I had glasses. I had my glasses from upstairs that are in the car.
I don't know if I could read it from that distance either.
Could you throw it up there? Just
yeah, let me try.
Maybe, Marilis, if you make it large, I might.
Well, the thing is, it'll cover you up. Like.
Okay.
And which is what this one does.
Yeah, what translation do you have here?
This is ESV.
Which one is it, ESV?
Yes.
Okay. I'll try to, in what scripture, what?
This is Ephesians 6:12.
Okay.
I had my mic up too high. There we go.
Okay, I'll try it this way, and we'll try it tonight. And what verse? Oh, you start 12. Okay.
6:12.
Oh wait, mine doesn't. Yeah, mine I have to just say it to the end. Like, what is the end?
Oh, 6:12 to 24.
Okay. We'll see if it lets me do that.
Yeah, and I can. We can try this out, and this might be the easier way to do it.
Yeah, we'll try it. And here we are, folks. Hello, David Arndt, and. That was Laura. You're right. That was her. And here we read it here. This is a long one, so I'm going to get some water. In fact, Mary Elizabeth, do you mind refilling this? Would you mind refilling this? The doctor wants me to drink a lot of water. Just pray for me. I had a little, kind of a high test of a certain thing in my blood test, which probably can come from I overworked. I worked out too much for too long, and create my muscles just have too much. They're dumping off something called CK. And so drinking water should help. I'm going to go back for another blood test, but probably a sign of overwork and inflammation of muscles. So pray for me. And here it says, for we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Now, that's all under the blood of Jesus. It's all part of the deal, all defeated. As we see in Colossians 2, this they were defeated and chained up and brought in a victory procession, and we're in the front of the chariot. In those days, they would have a chariot and kind of a parade of prisoners. We're in the chariot with the conqueror, Jesus. Can you believe that? And they're all walking like this. But they still threaten and hiss and try to get in there. And if we give openings, then we're kind of going toward the defeated side. We're kind of saying, yeah, I want some defeat in my life too. So here Paul tells us how. Thanks a lot, Mary Elizabeth. Paul tells us how not to be defeated. When I'm finished with this, I'll be finished with my gallon today. Okay.
That water slurp. I should have turned the mic down.
Yeah, I slurp a little. Yeah. I slurp. I can't help it. Oh, man, I made the print kind of huge here.
You should be able to pinch zoom.
Yeah, I thought I could.
Are your fingers wet?
I don't think so. Anyway, I wish you could just command it to say, go smaller, go
tech
smaller.
Support.
Yeah. But anyway.
Tech support.
But anyway, therefore, and then this is how we actually get the solution to these evil powers trying to ruin us. And here it says, therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand an evil day. And he tells you basically, and he says, and having done all to stand firm. And here's how you do it. Got a couple of visitors. Hello there. Girls, how you doing? Katie and Lauren. And so, therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand an evil day, and having done all to stand firm. Stand therefore, having fastened on. There are six things here. Now, this might be a little, take another few minutes, but it'll be well worth it, because this is how you win it. Win a victory. Stand therefore, having fastened on the belt of truth. First of all, you got to stay in the truth. You can't even give in to white lies or compromises or exaggerations. And then also, after the belt of truth, you put on the breastplate of righteousness. And another translation says integrity. You know, you want to have integrity. And you can't be fooled when you want to have integrity and have the inside of your cup be as good as the outside and be true all the way through to your core. And then it says, as shoes for your feet, having put on the readiness given by the gospel of peace. I like this one, because instead of being defeated, you're actually putting on your tennis shoes, you're putting on your sneakers, you're actually going forward with Jesus, hand in hand, taking ground, bringing light into darkness, touching the lonely, the sick. You're making a difference. And then you keep going and put on the, in all circumstances, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming darts of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying at all times in the Spirit with all prayer and supplication. And, you know, to that end, keep alert with all perseverance, making supplication for all the saints. And see, here we are doing that. We're praying for each other.
Do you know, I don't know if you've heard this, but apparently the shields they had were made of a very soft wood that would absorb darts and extinguish them.
Yeah, neat.
Yeah, and it wasn't, and that's, you know, what it means to extinguish the flaming darts.
Sure.
You know, it's interesting to realize, you know, given the context of how they were saying, how Paul meant to write this, is that, you know, it was like modern military terms in a way, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, also, Paul himself asked for continued prayer for that he might continue to give out the mystery, proclaim the mystery of the gospel in boldness. So we pray that for us, and help us to continue to be clear cut about this, would you? And keep supporting us. One thing I like about this, and Derek Prince pointed out, did you ever notice that the armor described by Paul, that it covers everything except one area? It doesn't cover the back. And he said that as long as you're walking toward the darkness, and don't flee. You're invulnerable. You're invincible. And Jesus walked toward the darkness because he had the light. There's no fear. If we run and flee, then we are vulnerable to getting hit in the back, you know, with an arrow. So all you have to do is just keep, you wouldn't think of fear as a sin, but it's a way of being defeated. And we don't want to give in to fear. Just keep by faith, even if you have to just remind yourself, no, I'm invincible. As long as I keep moving forward, I'm invincible. Because look, everything's covered, you know. I'm going on offense because you already are. You have the victory if you keep going forward with Jesus. So anyway, that was a good one. And I want to catch up on messages, including just saying hi to people. Yeah, and Chandra, you know about that, CK? Yeah, let me know. Maybe you can always message me. Did you have that? And also, I know I have to even I drink a gallon a day, but I do. I have been working out way just maybe too much, and you know I might have just. Maybe I need to drink even more. And also, Tim Underwood, I don't know if I said hello to you, but good evening. You know what I did? I was editing some more of the Vine Valley movie. So glad your team was in there with the bright yellow uniforms and you let us film you. So we still have you in the movie. I pray that we get across the finish line right now. It's going to be like three movies. It's almost like a trilogy all in one. So pray for us. Pray for God's anointing. If you or any other local folks want to come over here and visit us, you could drop in. It's almost like an open house or coffee house atmosphere on Wednesdays and Wednesday evenings and Sunday afternoons, okay? And let's see here. Who else is here? Laura's here. We said hello to Laura. David Arndt, our youngest. Are you nearby, David? Anyway.
Not sure where he is.
Okay. Jacob's down here. Are you in Florida still, Jacob? I guess so. Their flight doesn't leave until tomorrow. They gave us some beautiful pictures from there today. My favorite was when they were on top of the St. Augustine Lighthouse with the background, the ocean or the sound or whatever it is in the background.
Yeah, I got to go on the top of the same lighthouse.
The same one.
Some years back, yeah.
Wow, what memories. Well, Alyssa says hello. Good to see Alyssa down there in the Bayou State, Louisiana. Okay, well, let's go to the next song. I'll check the messages. Also, any private messages that might come in, you're welcome to send those. And we'll see where we are at the end of the song to see if we're going to wind down or if there's more to talk about.
James, technical difficulties. I stepped on the wire. Okay, I think we're plugged in again. Alrighty. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. Change my heart, oh God. Make it ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. You are the potter, I am the clay. Mold me and make me, this is what I pray. It ever true. Change my heart, oh God. May I be like you. You are the potter, I am the clay. My heart, oh God.
Hey, back again, folks. Back again. This is kind of cozy by the fire, you know? All we need is some snow outside and play the song Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire. Can you play that one?
I probably could.
He can sing it.
Can you sing it?
He can do his Nat King Cole impression.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Caleb's also able to imitate all of our batting stances on the softball team. I don't know how you do that, but you can actually go in the middle of a room and imitate each one of us.
Caleb, one of my goals. Hey, wait, we don't have someone sitting in that chair. I'm going to turn a camera towards you.
Yeah, go ahead.
But it'll take me a moment.
This way you can see Caleb, folks. In the meantime, catching up, and I appreciate the sister who wrote to us during the two messages during the break. One was someone who's watching. Good to see our friend who's watching tonight. And the other one is a woman who wrote me earlier today and needs real prayer for her son. And she lives up there in northern Indiana. So God bless her. She's a member of this community. And also, I just wanted to say, refer to two messages here, Donna, Dean Casper, about putting on the armor as I got dressed in the morning. And that's a really good idea for everybody. Boy, that's a good one. Enid said, I never heard it explained that way, Pastor. I guess you mean the armor, and that's Derek Prince, the late Derek Prince, who said that. I picked that up. Chandra, I appreciate that medical advice. Maybe I could talk to you about I'd appreciate getting more understanding about this. And, I worked out a tremendous amount, especially before I took the test. And this was just an incidental finding, and they were trying to explain because I've had a lot of muscle. I do work out probably too much, but it really blows off a lot of steam for me. And you do the Fitbit, and I've been doing averaging probably, 20,000 plus steps a day, then sometimes working out also with weights or whatever. And, maybe I did put myself a little over the edge. Hello, Mercy. Good to see you. Mercy from Virginia, the good old great state of Virginia, where Kathy and I honeymooned in 79. And we tried to go back there. Since our 25th anniversary, we've been able to go back to Colonial Williamsburg almost every year. On the way there, we had about 12 or 13 second honeymoons going back there since then. And what's kind of neat is every time we go through different parts of the South, Southeast, or East, or even Northeast. And we've gotten to see about 60 other things on the way there, lighthouses, mostly Civil War sites, Southern mansions. If anybody knows of any good Southern mansions, we visit a lot of them, or just Civil War sites. We really love seeing those things. I'm always reading some kind of diary about the Civil War, or those days, or slavery, or freedom, abolition. It's just fantastic. Revivals in both the North and the South happened, and it's just really fascinating. We even include a little of that in the Vine Valley movie. It's not a setback then, but we include it a little bit. And by the way, if anybody's interested in being an extra, we have a few missing parts in Vine Valley, and we could just rush it, but we're 98% of the way finished, and we know God's gonna, as he did with the rest of the movie, be very specific about, he's the one who cast it, you know? David O. Selznick, when he was doing Gone with the Wind, in 37 or so, a lot of the actresses were being reviewed to see who would play Scarlett O'Hara. He went through a lot of them, and he was very patient. And filming started about 2 years later. They were filming The Burning of Atlanta, and they still didn't have Scarlett picked out, and they had to show Scarlett in that scene. Now, do you remember that scene, The Burning of Atlanta? Thankfully, it was a distant scene, and Rhett Butler had to rescue, Melanie and the baby in the back of the wagon, and the horse, they had to cover the horse's face with something so that the horse wouldn't be intimidated by the flames.
It's probably because they didn't have the horse picked out either.
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry.
A stunt horse. And they hadn't selected the horse either. Hello, Christine Yazzie from New Mexico.
That nationwide search didn't get as much publicity as the Scarlet Search.
So, yeah. And they had to film that scene without knowing who would play Scarlet, but they had a stunt Scarlet in there at a distance. It didn't matter who it was. And to make a long story short, that evening while they were on the set, that's when Vivian Leigh was introduced to David O. Selznick by David's brother, Myron, who is an agent. And I think he said, almost literally, he turned to David O. Selznick and he said, hey, genius, here's your Scarlett. Turned out to be a woman who spoke from England with his English accent. They had to do a crash course and teach her to speak Southern. And she did a pretty good job, didn't she, in the movie? And Christine says, beautiful background dad. Yeah, I think it's a good idea. We used to do our Save at Home show sometimes in front of a fireplace. April Fool's Day, which happens to be my birthday, is the 22nd anniversary of when we started doing the Safe at Home show. But 13 months ago was the first time we did it with live listeners. We don't call it Safe at Home anymore, of course. We call it Conversations with Dad. What we were talking about right before, the Civil War sites. If anybody knows any southern plantations, we visit a lot of things, lighthouses, Civil War sites. We want to go back to Shiloh. That's one we haven't gone back to for a while. But almost every other one we've gotten to see. And in the north, too, Gettysburg. And one of our favorite ones is the prison camp at Andersonville. We've read several autobiographies of the soldiers, and it's really touching. There were revivals there. There were revivals all over the place. When people get into tough times, there have been revivals. They don't always make the history books. Enid says, one of my favorite movies. Well, that's what we're trying to do with this one, is create a good, be patient with it. It's 6 hours long. It's already a lot longer than Gone with the Wind, but it's going to be running probably on our new website, and we'll make a DVD. Keep praying that we can cross the finish line. We still have some key roles that have to be fulfilled, and one is, I can talk behind the scenes, but if anybody wants to come here during our May gathering, we might have to do a few extra scenes. They're simple, just maybe somebody would be in the background. It doesn't take anything except being yourself. And we could talk to you all. And there are a couple other ones that are going to be real specific to fill. And I feel like God almost said, just relax. I've done the other 98%. I'll do this too. Okay, well, I think we might be pretty well wrapped up. And does anybody else, do you have any questions? Our guests over here, Lauren and Katie? No, good to see you. It's kind of nice to see you in person after seeing you sometimes in here, especially Katie. You've been in here once in a while. Yeah.
Do you want to go to another song? Or?
Well, let's go to another song. And then if there's nothing more, we might sign off and say goodbye.
Bring me back to you.
Hey, Kathy, guess what? We had a guest from Florida, Mark, our son. I want to say hello to Mark, who came in just now. I bet you think we started at 8 p.m. Central, right? We actually came in at 7 p.m. Central. You might have, I don't know if, you know, I'm glad we went a little over 8, because those who don't know that we start on this one day of the week, we start an hour earlier, they might have just now come in. So maybe I'll just keep chatting a little while and just give it a chance, a few minutes at least, into the 8 o'clock hour, in case anybody out there is just grabbing their device and coming in. And in fact, you guys, if you want to stop playing, I think we, you know, your fingers are probably a little sore. If not, maybe we'll do Holy Is the Lord later, you know. That's what's hard?
It's a little hard.
Is that hard?
I think it was better.
Well, if you're going to talk, you should stand up so you can be on camera.
Oh, yes.
There he is.
Okay. And Mark says he likes a new fireplace. Mark, you've got a real eye for creativity. We just started doing this last week. Doesn't it remind you of our old Safe at Home shows? Would you realize that those shows, it'll be 22 years on my birthday, which is April Fool's Day. And so that we started doing that show. Of course, we didn't have you in there. We didn't have a live audience. It just aired on TV, and it most recently, for several years, aired on NRB. I don't know how many years, but a couple of years at least, on DirecTV, and not-for-profit Christian. By the way, speaking of not-for-profit, we're not-for-profit. In fact, there's no danger of a profit here. You know, so, yeah, but
I think no matter what, we'll be done. Yeah, non-profit for a little bit.
And we basically help. You know, we just know everything, every penny anybody gives, we won't see it. It'll just go straight into some bringing more people in here, advertising on Facebook.
They give thousands of pennies, we might see that.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, maybe someday if God really explodes it, we would start to, start to get into the ministry more, buy back some of our time from the work and all the other things. But right now, this is just a love of life. And Jackie says she remembers Safe at Home. Oh, do you remember that? Jackie, when it was on the NRB network? You know, yeah. We have it on, by the way, we have 50 episodes of that and 50 episodes of Fam Team from several years ago. We all look younger on safeathome.com. FamTeam.com, FamTeam.com. And we're going to try to, this is the 20th year of FamTeam.com. We're going to try to give it a facelift. And what I'm really excited about, we're going to make an app. We'll have it made for us. See, that's another thing. It's going to cost us like 27,000 base to do those two things. So it's just a leap of faith for us to do all this. And we're going to just try to reach out because, look what's happening in the pro-life world just by people reaching out on the internet and speaking out for the unborn. Already things are starting to change. There's a little pressure on our politicians to be more pro-life. The evidence of science, ultrasounds, the beating of the heart so early in the womb. People don't even know that, fingernails. And it just, we have to get the momentum going on that. So, I don't know, just if I should go forward. Or
maybe open the eyes of my heart.
Yeah, okay, let's do open the eyes of my heart and we'll see where we are. I like to err on the side of going longer rather than too short. And don't be bashful by asking a question or sending a private message. Just don't be bashful. Don't run away. Go toward it.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy. Shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, 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 to see you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your glory, pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy. Of my heart, I want to see you. I want to see you.
Well, we'll come back here, and I'm just looking through some of the messages here, and Jackie has a prayer request for her daughter, and that's, she's Mary Elizabeth's age. Yeah, God, just bless this girl as she graduates from criminal justice, well, a young woman, and she'll be interning with your sheriff's department. And then she'll be starting with the police academy. God, we do pray for her safety. We thank God for those who do serve in this way. I have a tremendous respect for them and the risks that they take. There's a series I've been watching. It's on Tuesday evenings. I don't know if anybody's ever seen it. It's called Body Cam. And basically, since a lot of officers wear these, it just shows the scrapes that they get into and the danger so quickly. It can go from a routine day of patrolling to a dangerous situation, but they make it through, you know, in almost every instance through their tremendous training, their teamwork, through by selflessly protecting each other and knowing, just like we talked earlier about wearing the armor of God, you know, just we talked earlier about, and if anybody missed that, go back and replay. It's probably worth listening to. It's something we all need to hear, but they know how to go into, you know, you're guaranteed a success when you do that as a Christian. See, there are certain areas that are set up as safe zones with God. When you obey God and you won't sin, you're on safe. You act completely invincible to anything the evil spirits would do, or the world could do, or your own flesh could do to tempt you. It's very, very clear. In fact, we can just say all three. Maybe you can go to the first letter of John, and all three are mentioned. John is writing saying you have overcome the world, the flesh. And basically, we'll talk about that. But I just wanted to say that you're guaranteed of success. But that's kind of a good analogy. Those in the police academies and those who serve, just want to tip a hat and just appreciate so much what they do and how you think of people like that who serve should be paid, you know, so highly, and yet, you know, sometimes they have trouble making ends meet. So we want to surround them and support them and make it easy on them to do their jobs. And God bless your daughter and God bless those who train her in Jesus' name. It's a wonderful thing that she's doing. And it's good. Did I say hello to you, Tiffany? Good to see you. Saw you earlier today, too. And nice to have local people in here as well. And it was great to be for our family to be associated with your big day, your wedding. And you and Carney were here at the, we call him that, Jesse. And we're here at,
now.
Yeah, they're both by that name now. Thanks for sitting so patiently while we had our little classic. We hope that's going to grow as we reach out now into the country and beyond. We think that we're going to try to really grow and kind of, I jokingly call it multiply the rabbits, but we're really going to try to go forward this year and multiply. So would everybody please do a watch party, invite others in. And really God did it. He sent Jesus once and for all to sacrifice on the cross for everybody, whoever was born, whoever will live. And he basically paid for all their sins to be forgiven and really gave them a reservation in heaven if they accept it. The only conditions are The only difference is some people accept and some don't. Someone will just live their own lives, not live according to God's will, and they're just willing to live apart from God. So how can they go to heaven? They don't want him. They don't want him. So all we have to do is say, yeah, I do want you, and I want you more than these other things, and I love pleasing you. I don't care about peer pressure. Besides, anybody who stands up and loves God really winds up getting more friends. It's just a lie to say that any other way that you'll lose, any of us will ever lose anything by saying a complete yes to God.
I think that verse you were looking for is 1 John 2:13.
Okay.
I don't know if you want to pull it up on your phone and try that again.
Yeah, let me do that. Let me see. 1 John 2:13, ESV. And this should, here we go. And you have it up there too, right?
Yep.
I am writing to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I am writing to you, young men, because you have overcome the evil one. I write to you, children, because you know the Father. And there's a little more about defeating the world and the flesh and the devil. I'm not sure if that one's coming through, but...
I'll go to this.
Okay.
I'll follow along.
Is it the same? Is it the same section, though?
Sorry, what
It says they defeated all three, the world, the flesh, and the devil.
Well.
Just a minute, folks.
Might be later than this. Did I
no problem.
The right spot?
Or
if you can find it right there.
I can't find it right now, but what I'll do is I'll just kind of tell you about it, folks. Basically, there are three things that we face as humans, and one is our own sinful natures. We're born, Adam and Eve fell, and we all became tainted, you know, and we need a savior. We're prone. Our flesh is prone to, it's kind of like you never have to teach a little kid to say I and me and my. We have a basic propensity to put ourselves at the center of the universe. And the only way that can be broken, it's not just, you're not able to have self-improvement or being religious. You really have to have an encounter with God and kind of get it all taken care of, because we can't ever cross that Grand Canyon and make it to heaven or earn heaven. Anytime we're really conscious of our sins of commission or omission, you really just have to believe in what Jesus did. And once we put our trust in what he did, we can relax and let his spirit change our hearts. And then the spirit fills us, and our spirit then is stronger than our flesh. There might be little tussles, but we've won the battle. We might have to still take ground, like conquer this part of you, conquer that part of you. And secondly, the world. Instead of being sucked in by a fallen world, we actually help suck it in to bring light to it. And thirdly, evil spirits, which are very real, but they're defeated. Especially if we're obeying God, there's just no way we're completely going to roll over all darkness. But if you're opening doors and disobeying God, then you're sort of vulnerable. You're actually like walking around without any kind of armor. So you have to just live with that armor, live close to God, and you can go on offense then. And I want to say hello to Danielle. I haven't seen you for a while. Good to see you. You're welcome to come. Good to see. We were just talking today about, I was reading about Civil War history again, and I actually mentioned to Kathy, yeah, you know, it's neat. Danielle says she's related to these folks in Virginia from the 1700s or whatever. So it's nice that you're in here tonight. Come on over anytime for our meetings. Well, anyway, folks, thanks for being here. I think we've pretty well gone across the finish line for tonight. We'll be here tomorrow, 2 p.m. Central. I'll do one by myself, and then we'll be back here at 8 p.m. Central. Good to see you. You can feel free to send a message, as always, after the show. Good night.